you cooking up, Ron?
Some bacon.
Bacon?
Bacon and linguica. Got some linguica coming up.
Look at that. Ooh. Smells really good.
Yep. Figure this is a good campsite to have a good breakfast at.
Yep. Good cup of coffee and a...
Beautiful this morning.
Hearty breakfast, huh?
Yep.
Can't beat this view, guys. Currently, we are in the El Paso Mountains, Mojave Desert. Temperature is right around 61 right now. It's about 8:55 in the morning. So we're about wrapped up. We're gonna pack up and we're gonna work our way down to Garlock Road and head north to intersect 395. That's the plan. Head into maybe Lone Pine or Bishop. Restock up on some items and head into our next destination. So we will catch you guys in a bit. All right, guys, so we've come to the end of the road. Can't go any further. Road's washed out. There's a massive gully, and so we're not gonna chance it. We're way back in here, and it's not worth taking a chance trying to cross this washout. So we're gonna be hiking in first thing tomorrow morning to our destination, which is gonna be pretty cool. It's gonna be up this mountain range here. So that's it.
do all my own work, you know. He says, hey, man, what should I do here? I just had my F-150 lowered, and it's just a little higher in the back, man. Can you level it for me? Do you know what? Dude, I'm not into lowering. I have no idea what you can do to these things or what took to a shop. And they wanted more money to level it. After he paid to have it lowered.
Think back
don't you do a shackle?
Shackle flip.
Shackle reverse?
No, they put long shackles on.
Yeah. Think back in high school, when a guy wanted to lower his Chevy, put floor jacks underneath the frame, about 2 inches lower, and just take a torch and heat the fucking springs. Boom, let it hit the jack stands, and away we went, man.
And it's like doing this down the road. Yeah. You're bouncing.
And then what guys used to do, what guys used to do on like your 55 Mercury's and stuff like that, get a crowbar and you flip that fucking shackle the other way. You know how it's up? They would boom, put it down. The spring would be down and it would give you a button.
That way, Rudy seems to think it's going to be to the right, but I think it's up and still around up in there.
It goes to the left, and it goes
I think
up.
So. Yeah.
It continues on up, so.
Let's go, buddy.
I had a friend of mine who went to the King of the Hammers when it first happened.
Yeah.
He's not into hiking. He wants to hike back there and get back into the canyon.
Yeah.
He's going to sit at the church and drink beer all day. Okay.
There you go.
We are slowly but surely making our way up. It's a slow climb. A good pair of boots is mandatory. So you gotta be ready because your feet will thank you for it. Can't you go underneath a boulder?
No. Wow, okay, wait a minute. The hole right here.
What's below the boulder here? Nothing. The Hobbit. Good boy, Ranger. He makes it look easy. Gotta follow the poles up, more or less.
Awesome trail.
That's a trail.
Ooh, I think we lost the trail. Probably goes up this way. Use your nose, Ranger. We've been following the electrical poles, and we've been following these rock horns as well. So that's been very helpful. So we're in the trees now. we gotta find our way up here. Looks like the trail goes up this way, so get on this little ridge here and see where we're at. Maybe that'll give us an idea. Yes, I see a cabin out in the distance. I see a cabin and a window. So we are close. We just got a little further up to go. Let's go check it out, guys. That little footbridge, or what's left of that footbridge. That's pretty neat. Yeah, guys, we made it. Check out the Hilton here. Champion Hilton. Oh wow. This is so cool. It's very well maintained. Full-size bed over here. Another full-size bed over here. Some reading material. We're gonna have to fill out the logbook before we leave. Storage for plates, miscellaneous items, cleaning supplies. There's even an extra chair there. That's pretty cool. Plenty of firewood and your stove. The spark plug mine. That's pretty. cool. We're gonna follow this path here. They got old old rail here, cart rail. Look at this. This is pretty cool. Look at that. The old cellar here, or storage. That's the old door. Must have came off the hinges. You got your heavy duty locking mechanism. Yeah, they use like that's mortar right there. Stuff between the logs. Nice and tight seal. Wow, that's one heavy duty door. That feels super heavy. So this cabin here is the one right next to the cellar. So it's the one right above it. Oh, this one's a little beat up. This must be the washroom area. After a hard day's work, I think the miners came here and washed up. It's pretty cool. I heard somebody came up, some locals came up and vandalized a lot of these old cabins, man. Pretty messed up. Changing room, and then you had your shower. All plumbed. Then you have this building above the previous washroom. So this must have been sleeping quarters. It's probably locked from the other side. This is the kitchen area. This is so cool. Wow. This is awesome. It's very clean, by the way. Pots hanging off the joists. That's pretty cool. The old heavy duty sink. Stove. Load it up with some firewood. Then you got a nice hot cooktop on there.
at these old kettles. Look at this one. Oh, it's a cool old coffee pot there. Oh, look at this. It says clean out. Must have been a little access door for something. Wow, look at these old Coleman stoves. They don't build them like that anymore. That's for sure. And this must have been the pantry. Extra storage. Somebody's old sleeping bag hanging there. Old ice chest. I think this is the mess room. Let's go check it out. Oh yeah. So this is pretty much where everybody came in and ate their supper, breakfast, lunch. Three full-size beds with a cot. Yeah, this is pretty cool. And this is that one door we cannot open from the outside. Oh, the old guitar here. So this is the backside of that kitchen and mess room. Or mess hall. Wow. Just another sleeping quarters. This is pretty cool. Yeah, another wood burning heater. And the old pot here so you can heat up some water. Take a sponge bath. Check that out, guys. That's the old shower apparatus. That's pretty cool. This tank here will be filled up with water. They would place the firewood down below. Heat up the water, gravity feed the hot water by opening up that valve right there, and that will send the water over to your shower area. Door's missing. Okay, this is where the water would trickle out.
I don't know what this might be. I guess it's supposed to be artwork.
What else do you do up here, right?
They got miscellaneous hardware.
Old fittings.
Freaking jawbone.
Oh, this is pretty cool.
Old horn. Let's see what's in this shed. Okay, this is just a little shed, workshop shed. There's old pickaxes, just random stuff. Old tools, saws, whatever you might need to keep these cabins in tip-top shape. There's even a nice wheelbarrow, look at that. I wonder who brought that up here. And of course, a spare toilet seat for your outhouse. Rangers in here exploring as well. So this one's got your stove there. It's pretty nice. And you got a little collection of rocks there. Could be quartz. So they did mine a lot of quartz up in these mountains. Ranger, you want out? Go.
So I heard somewhere that the mines are still up in the hills here.
Yeah, 2 miles up.
Gosh, this is something up here. I've always wanted to come up to see these, man, but I didn't want to come alone.
Well, yeah, coming up that freaking mountain range.
So I had to find two dummies that didn't know any better to come with me.